kind of record you.
Okay, so this is your assignment this week. This is one you're gonna do right now, live in class. And we're gonna do it together. All right. I got several yeses. When you're ready, let's go to ready. Say ready. Type ready in the chat when you're ready. So I know you're ready. Yeah, that's what I like to see. Lots of readies. Rest of you, wake up. Wake up. All right. So I'm going to tell you what to draw. I'm just going to tell you to draw something, and then you'll interpret what I said to draw, however you interpret it. Draw a geometric shape in the middle area of your canvas. All right. I want you to draw an organic shape that overlaps that geometric shape in some way. Starting anywhere on your page. Move somebody in here. Starting anywhere on your page, we're going to begin a line. I want that line to go about halfway across your page. I want it to turn in any direction and go straight in a different direction. And then stop and then turn in another direction and continue. And then stop and come back to the original point you started at. Yeah. Yep. What? You got to interpret. There's not a link. You can just use Chrome Canvas or you can just use paper. Chrome Canvas link, you need the link to Chrome Canvas. Guys, you all should bookmark this because you don't want to have to be in class to be able to go to the site. That's all right. I'm late to things on very, very rare occasion. I hate to be late. My motto is, if I'm on time, I'm late. All right. So again, if you don't get the instructions perfect, it's okay. It's how you interpret them to begin with. All right. Now, we should have some shapes that are intersecting or broken in. So we should have some geometric shapes. We should already have some organic shapes going on. I would like for you to find three shapes, any three shapes that have been created, and fill them with warm color. I'm going to give you a minute on this one because I know this one's going to take you just a second because you got to, take one more time for saying, excuse me, than just drawing a line. I'll give you a couple minutes. Any three of the shapes that are created as all of these lines and shapes have intersected, any of the small shapes, any three of them, or any of the shapes that are created, I should say, you're going to fill with a warm color. You're gonna find then two shapes and fill them with a cool color. Any two shapes and fill them with a cool color. So you'll have three shapes that you've got some warm colors in and two shapes that you've got some cool color in. All right. And then the very last thing we're going to do on this one is we're going to create a line that is going to be your movement of the eye. How do you think you want the eye to go through this work of art? So you're going to take a literally like a and make a line that starts in the point where you think the eye would initially begin in your work of art. You're going to look at it and draw a line that you think describes how the art is traveling. Noemi, that's awesome. If you can, on your Google, you should be able to go into your Google Chrome, whatever, and join us from that tablet as well. And then you can share out. You can hold it up also, but it's hard to see those bright screens. I love seeing stuff on tablets. So again, that last instruction is you're going to draw one line that goes through the work of art in the way that you believe the eye should travel through that work of art that you've created. Okay. Everybody got that? All right. So if you did yours on paper, oh my God, this is going to be the most dreaded moment of the class. You need to turn your camera on and hold it up over where your face would go, because God forbid you let us see your face. But you got to let us see your art, okay? So put the art in front of the camera if you just absolutely can't be seen. You don't have to do it on paper. If you did it on Chrome Canvas, I'm going to stop my share and let you share. Yeah. But you're either going to have to turn your camera on and show. Awesome. Well, I like it. That's excellent. And so also mine here too. They'll all be very, very different. But we'll look at the movement that's created and sort of where this area of emphasis is created. Here we can see that where those bright colors are in the center of Linda's is exactly where that area of emphasis is created, and kind of where our eye moves to. All right, let's see. Let me do my stop share. If you would like to share your awesome artwork, seriously, guys, turn these cameras on and hold something up. Arr. You know, my second graders, they all have their cameras on. Gabrielle, that's great. And again, so yours is because of the sort of the way you did the line and sort of the direction. I get a real depth, spatial depth looking at it, as if your eye kind of goes back into the center of that space, as if you got kind of single point perspective count. Really good. Yes, you really need to share. Dominic, very well done. I like it. And again, his is very organized. If you think about the way, I'll show you mine here. Mine is not organized at all. And so think about how our brains do things differently, of course. Okay. I'm watching time. We got time to do another one. So, no, we can't do it on Jamboard because everybody just messes everybody else's up. It'd be nice if we could, but you all do a little better. The second, third graders, goodness, they're just like mean with Jamboard. you need to be able to turn these in individually. You're going to do two drawings today. So this is my first one. And you can see it's very disorganized. I've got that black line that kind of shows you where I think the eye should kind of move from large space. And the intent for me is, I believe most of us look at art by beginning in the top left-hand corner, like we're reading a page, particularly in the United States, where that's how we read. And so we tend to start here. Our eyes generally want to go this direction. I think because the area, the reds here in the way these lines and verticals kind of encourage your eye this direction back and forth. And so hopefully you're examining what you've created and you've drawn a line that kind of describes how you think that eye would travel through your work of art. So, yeah, you guys are the worst shares I've ever seen. All right. So I'm gonna leave my jam board up because but I'm gonna do my not jam board. Share screen here. All right, and so real quick, we're gonna look at the work of this fella. His name is Jackson Pollack. Before we do that, let me see here. Guys, if you didn't already, please do the attendance check-in. Yep, that's not it. Attendance check-in. In the chat, if you didn't already, it looks like most of you did. I think I'm showing 27 in here. We got 20 run responses, there's 26. So there's 5 of you that still need to do a daily check-in. Guys, if you aren't putting your first and last name here each day, you're not really getting full attendance. You're not getting attendance for those days. You're going to tell me how do you feel. You're going to then tell me if you have any questions. So 3 basic, easy things that take very long. Doesn't taste very long either. I don't know that. Okay. 21 requests, 20 responses. So far, most of you are sleepy. Well, most of you, I guess, are ready to work. That's good. A little upset, a couple upset. 3D animation. Oh, yeah. I've got a couple of different classes I'm actually working on. 3D animation one's not ready yet. The animation one, the post March 1st. If you are interested in learning about animation, I'll send you the link to that when you can do it. You can be one of my beta students testing out the class, how it works. If you're interested in 3D animation, you'll have to wait till the end of March, probably the 1st of April, before I get that one posted, because it's longer. It's taking longer to finish. I still need 2 more of you to finish. Okay. Jackson Pollack is an abstract expressionist. And we're not going to go into everything because I want to do a painting and we're going to do it quickly. But his paintings were designed to keep the eyes of the viewer moving the entire time you look at it. And he would do these big, huge works of art on him. He had a barn in his as a studio. And what did I do? Did I hit the wrong thing? Why did I do that? And if you'll notice, this is a secondary module. They've got better stuff than you all do. Isn't that sad? I hate to say that. It's true, though. So meet Pollack. Well, not go to the right page. There we go. He's got rhythm. Sorry. So he would work in the studio, and he would do these big drippy paintings all over the canvas. And the way he would work is he would listen to jazz music. And I love listening to music when I make art. And he would do the same sort of thing. He would lay out these big, huge canvases. He would get big buckets of house paint. And he would stand over the work of art and drip on it as he listened to music. And he would move his body in unison with the music so that the work of art he would create would have this spontaneity, would have the energy of his body and the music and everything. And if you would look at it, this is one of the works of art. You don't have to have a lot of color, as you can see. Now, he did have some that were very bright colored as well. So how you choose, use colors up to you. But we're going to listen to music, and in the last 4 minutes of class, we're going to make art. So get your other piece of paper ready. Yeah, after class, stick around if you want to. And we'll do your DBA. And you can share out also. All right, we're going to listen to music, and we're going to do a Jackson Pollack-inspired work of art. Let me stop my share here. Oh, here we go again. All right. Start my share here. All right. Let's get some music going. All right. You'll see me. I'm going to move my body. I'm going to make some art. You're just going to make some really cool art that interprets how you respond to that music. and let's pick a good song. Any requests? The chat disappeared. I don't know what they would be if you had. Where did my... Any requests on the music? I don't have dance. Do I have Dance Monkey? Okay, let's look at the playlist. Sorry, I may have confused everyone. This is my playlist. The same awful music we listen to every day because I know it's safe and it's not off of a website. All right, I want to check the chat. Any requests? Yeah, that's why the Beatles. Do I have the Beatles on there? Ah, that's not what I want to do. Let's see. How about let's do some Car Wash. Can everybody hear it? Oh, the Zootopia song. Yeah, let's do the Zootopia song. I'd rather listen to that anyway. Hold on. Wait. Yeah, that's a better one to do. That was too slow. Shakira. There we go. Good call. And you're just making music with the lines. Try to interpret what the music's doing. How does it make you respond? Think about how your lines interact with each other and how your eye kind of travels over and under spaces. Think about how maybe light and dark, the value plays into it. All right, whatever you got, that's what you got. All right, let's do one more share out. Turn on all those screens, all the screens on. You guys are never gonna go. Let's see. Let me get. I gotta do a stop share. I can't. Hold on. I'm on too many devices. I'm too old for all of this. Oh, nice. Excellent. Julia, Gabby, those are fantastic. Dominique, that's got a ton of energy. And Linda, I love your color choices. Charbel, that's excellent. I like that you got a lot of energy going on that, even though you obviously didn't have a ton of crayons to choose from. Ariana, that's a wonderful. I love anybody using, again, Linda, those digital media. Those things are my favorite. I love using those. And if you're using Chrome Canvas, if you're using Nice Journey, I love it. So even if you don't really work like this on a normal basis, it's a great way to start before you start creating art to begin with, is to get in and just create and get your body moving, because it kind of gets you in that mode for creating art. Okay. The link to submit that, where I saved it on the tablet, apparently isn't working. I checked this morning, but it'll be working this afternoon. You're going to turn in both of those. You can turn them out on one piece of paper, on one photograph, hold them up both next to each other is fine. But you'll turn both those in for this week's assignment. Super easy week. Have a great weekend. If you have not done your DBA, stick around. We're going to do it real quick. Bye, guys. I'll give everybody a couple minutes to step out and we'll start doing DBA. Guys, if you're going to stick around for DBA, open up a Jamboard. Bye, guys. If you've done your DBA, get out of here. See you guys. If you are sticking around to your Jamboard DBA, open up a Jamboard. You can go to your Waffle in the Google page, on the Google homepage. Which assignment was that Jamboard? This week's assignment is what we're going to turn those artwork in. If you did it on Jamboard, that's fine too. You can share it with me on Jamboard. That's another way you can make this art. Yeah, I should have said that. If you did that, that's fine too. Just share it out with me. You'll still have to shoot. You'll still have to submit something, like at least submit a link that, hey, I shared out the Jamboard with you or something. Because unless you submit something, I can't grade it. Does that make sense? Let's see. Open a Jamboard if you're doing DBA. Make the title your name. Says great art DBA, something like that. And you want 4 pages. On each of those 4 pages, I'm going to ask you to choose a work of art as soon as I get that shared. So again, if you haven't already, you will go to Google homepage. You'll go to your Waffle. You'll go to Jamboard. You're going to open up a Jamboard. You're going to click plus and you're going to make a new one. And then you're going to title it your name, DBA, seventh grade, something like that. You'll see there are lots of them already here. Those are all the people who've done so many of their own already. There's the original PowerPoint, or the original Jamboard. I mean, I really like Jamboard, y'all can see. So create a Jamboard that you can share with me. Again, I'll put my email address is here in Scribble. jim.mcguire@fayette.kyschools. You're going to share that with me, make me an editor, or make the thing editor or editable, make me an editor, so I can edit it, and I'll put little green post notes next to everything you got right, and maybe red or orange or pink notes if you need to add a little more information. Is everybody ready? If you are ready, type in the chat DBA ready. I'm ready. If you already have your answers, Arlo, just share it out with me and you're good to go. And then Monday, I'll give you the Giovanni, for your DBA, yes, you're making a Jamboard. If you've already done your DBA, I don't know if you have. I don't think you have. I didn't see it. No, I didn't see one. Yeah. And Dominic, if you already did it last week, you're good. This is just if you didn't make it last week. Yeah. Yeah, if you've already done yours, get out of here. Get out of here. If you've got one of these Jamboards you shared with me already, you don't need to do this again. This is just if you were not able to get to the Zoom meeting for whatever last week. Yeah. Bye, guys. All right. Going once, going twice. So what you're going to do is I'm going to ask you about 4 different principles of art, and you are going to choose any one of these nine works of art. You can just label the number, or you can do a little snip and clip if you want to take a capture, a picture of the image. And that way you can draw on it. That's one of the reasons I like Jamboard. You're more than welcome to do that and bring that picture in. Or you can just, like I say, say I'm responding to artwork number 5. And I think it shows this principle of art because it does this and this and this. And you'll be very specific and have several sentences, not just one. All right. So let's see. Hold on. I got it's down here. Give me 1 second. Giovanni, are you in or not? It looks like you're coming back in again. Oh, yeah, sorry. I saw that. Noemi, what to do it after the DBA if you don't care. All right. And then okay, so you're going to choose number one on the first slide. You're going to make a text box. You can put it on a great big post-it note, whatever you want to do. But you're going to answer this question and how choose any one of these works of art and explain how did the artist create unity or harmony, unity/harmony. So you might say, and I'm not going to tell you what to say, but you might say, I'm going to respond to artwork number 8, and the way the artist created artwork or created unity and harmony in this work of art is through his use of this element of art, and this is how he used it to create unity, and this element of art, and this is how he created it, how he used it to create unity and harmony. Talk about the ways he used 2 or 3 different elements. How did those impact that unity and harmony? Any work of art, doesn't have to be number 8. Any ones you like. And I'll give you about 2 minutes to kind of put that answer together. Then we'll go on to number 2. If you'll type ready once you get your answer done, I'll kind of get a sense of. Looks like we got 4 that are taking it. No, Emmy, you're not taking it really, are you? You're just here waiting. That's right, Giovanni. So you'll just write, if you want to, you can just write down the number of, say, I'm responding to artwork number, whichever number you're going to talk about. And then you're going to explain in detail, really, how the artist is using a couple of the different elements to create that. Remember, elements are things like line, shape, color, texture, value, principles like variety, rhythm, anything that we've studied about, just to explain a couple of those different elements, principles, how they're being used to create unity or harmony in any one of these works of art. So once you've got that done, just type ready in the chat and I'll know we can move on. Thank you, Alyssa. We'll move on in just a second. As soon as you get done with yours, and take your time, I don't want to rush anybody, just type ready, and then when I get at least 3 or 4 readies, we'll talk about the next one. Somebody left. No, I mean, are you taking, you already did yours, didn't you? You're just waiting around to show me. Yeah. Give it just a second. As soon as I spit the third one out, we'll take a look. At the fourth one, I mean. Sorry. Okay, Jacob Giovanni, I'm going to go ahead and just explain what the next one is, but you can still take your time and write. On the second slide, on the second, you'll click this little arrow and it'll make a second page. On the second page, you're going to choose any one of these works of art and explain how the artist created a focal point or area of emphasis. How did the artist create a focal point or area of emphasis? So Jacob and Giovanni, if you haven't finished it with number one, you can go ahead to number two and just put a little post-it note that says focal point / area of emphasis, so you know that's what you're talking about when you get to number two. Number one was unity and or harmony, and number two is focal point or emphasis. If you want, you can go ahead and click the little arrow and create a third page. Giovanni, the second one is to describe, choose any one of these works of art and describe how an artist is creating a focal point or area of emphasis. And I'm actually going to change the third one for you all because I didn't love all the responses I got from the third one I had before. So I'm going to see if this one better prepares you all for the your test group. All right. So if you want to click and make a third page, you can just put a post-it note that explains what you're going to talk about. And the third one is going to deal with balance. Explain what type of balance the artist has created and explain how the artist has achieved balance using the elements and principles of art. We're going to try balance. We'll see how this one goes. Number three is balance. Yeah, and I'll go ahead and tell you, the fourth one is variety. Variety, rhythm, pattern, that sort of thing. You can talk about any of those. Oh, excuse me, no, just variety, not rhythm, pattern. Variety, and number four. So the first one is to choose any work of art, explain how the artist has created unity or harmony. The second is to choose any one of these works of art and explain how the artist has created a focal point or area of emphasis. The third is to describe, as to choose any one of these works of art, identify what kind of balance it has, and how did the artist achieve that type of balance, and how are the elements of art used to create balance? And finally, variety. Explain how any one of these works of art is using variety are using elements of art to create variety. How is variety being created by the artist in any of these works of art? Third one is balance. What kind of balance and how are they creating that balance using the elements of art? And once you got that, you're free to go. And just share that out with me. Make sure you get set to editor, and I'll put my name in the chat. Yeah. How? What type of balance? That's the first thing you want to identify. Number three, what kind of balance is it? And then second of all, how do they create that type of balance? Remember we talked about symmetrical, asymmetrical, radial types of balance. What type of balance did they create, and how are they creating it using the different elements? Yeah. If you've got to go, hold on, Noemi, you're gonna get shared. Let me type this in the chat here. What is that? Why did that come up? I hate ads. Microsoft doing this. Why are they doing this? All right, hold on. Noemi, I'm gonna let you share. Just let me put my. Yeah, there you go. All right. Noemi, you can do share screen. Let me do a stop share. All right, guys. Last time I'm going to go over these. You can choose one. If you need me to post it back up here in a second, let me know. But the last one was variety. Balance was number three. Variety was number four. Okay. Not just what type it has, Giovanni. Explain how did they achieve that type of balance, and how are they using the elements of art, at least a couple of them, to create that type of balance and that balance in art, and that work of art. No, let me go ahead and share. Let's see. Did I click the button? Yeah, sorry, share. Did you create this on Procreate? Nice. Wow, I really like your pollack one. There's some, first of all, that shape, that lightning bolt shape you've created is really nice. But the movement it creates is spectacular. And I really like this pattern background that you've got created. There's a real sense of depth. Now, part of that's created by actually having that black. The background automatically gives that sense of depth. Sweet. Very nice. And I like the way you interpreted the drawing. Everybody doesn't realize it, but the way I say you go from one point, turn, take another point, turn, take another point, it almost always makes the two triangles nose to nose, or they end up making a square. It's essentially what it ends up being otherwise. Giovanni, number four was, and I'll do my share screen. Noemi, those are excellent. Have a good day. Enjoy your math class. I don't know how anybody would enjoy math. All right, Giovanni, number four was variety. Choose any one of these works of art and describe how the artist is using a couple of the different elements to create variety. Alyssa, do you have any questions? Are you doing okay? You've been quiet. Okay. I just realized why I'm so sleepy. I've had one half of a Coke this morning, and I've usually had 12 cups of coffee by now. Time to feed coal to the engine. Fire up the main engines. So number one was unity, two, focal point, or area of emphasis. Number three was balance, and number four was variety. this will be the most boring make art video. I guess I'm going to stop recording now.